Good afternoon, Sergey.
Hi, I'm Michael Anderson. I'm a local GP here in Inverclyde. Your GP practice is the first point of contact for most patients. When you come in for an appointment, what you see is only a small part of practice life. You might see a receptionist answering a phone call, booking appointments, or a patient being given a prescription, but this is just some of the work that's going on. There's a lot we do that you might not see happening just under the surface. GP practice has and will continue to change. GPs now have access to services and support that complement your GP care. This might include advanced nurses attending home visits, pharmacists reviewing medications, nurses vaccinating in the community, and links workers supporting your social and well-being needs. They are all part of the wider GP team, and you may be directed to these professionals as they are the best person for your care. Our skilled reception staff may ask a few questions when you call. This is to help choose the right service for your needs. Our staff are all trained and your information will remain confidential. We are all working together to get you the right care at the right place. You will hear from some of the team to tell you a little bit about their role and when you might see them.
Hi, I'm Emily. I'm one of the charge nurses for Community Treatment and Care Services in Inverclyde.
Patients will know our service as the treatment rooms. In the future, we will be known as Community Treatment and Care, or CTAC for short. We have a team of trained and experienced nurses and healthcare support workers who work alongside your GP to provide services that you may have received in the past from your GP. Within this team, we provide a range of clinics across GP practices in Inverclyde. You might see our team for various treatments, for example, ear care, wound dressings, bloods and injections. Your GP practice will advise you if you need to attend our treatment rooms. If this is your first visit, our team will register you. This will only take 5 minutes and you can book an appointment at any of our Inverclyde sites. We have a range of treatment room services based in clinics and GP practices working from Greenock, Gourock and Port Glasgow health centres. You could book an appointment at any of our Inverclyde sites depending on availability. You may be directed to various new clinics as we change the way we deliver patient care.
And should you ever need us in the future, we look forward to welcoming you with care.
Hi, I'm Robin. I'm a pharmacist working in GP practice. Pharmacists, pharmacy technicians, and pharmacy support workers specialist knowledge in the safe use of medicines. You may hear from a member of the pharmacy team for a medication review to provide advice about your medicines or about changes to your medicines when you come out of hospital. Many pharmacists within the team can prescribe and some have special areas of interest. You may be asked to come to a clinic run by a member of the pharmacy team to discuss your medicines.
I'll now hand you over to my colleague in community pharmacy to explain other pharmacy roles.
Hi, I'm Wendy, a community pharmacist.
You also have the option of visiting a community pharmacist for advice and care. Our pharmacists and their teams are experts in medicines and can help with minor health concerns. A community pharmacist can give you advice and treatment under the Pharmacy First service. Allergies, constipation, hay fever, skin conditions, sore throat are some of the things we can help you with. If the pharmacist thinks it is better for you to see your GP, they may refer you directly or suggest you make an appointment. So pop in to your local pharmacist for help and support.
Hi, I'm Pauline McGrath, team leader for Housebound and Care Home Vaccination Programme within Inverclyde HSEB. As you know, vaccinations no longer take place within your GP practice. There are different vaccination programmes that are being delivered in a variety of settings, including health centres, schools, care homes and homes within the community. Childhood vaccinations have been delivered in health centres by our childhood vaccination team, and our school health vaccination team programme being delivered in schools will continue as before. seasonal flu will continue to be delivered locally by NHS vaccination teams in a variety of settings and also summer community pharmacists. COVID vaccinations are given locally by NHS vaccination teams and in various settings. Programmes including shingles and pneumococcal are being delivered by age, and you will be invited to attend at the appropriate stage. Midwives will continue to deliver pregnancy vaccinations, and please discuss this with your named midwife. All non-routine vaccinations will be delivered locally by the health board. For all information on vaccinations, please go to NHS Inform. Finally, for travel vaccinations and advice, these can now be accessed at Fit for Travel, which provides general advice and information on any vaccination you will require for your vacation. Please ensure you attend your appointment, as this will help in the prevention of disease. Thank you for working with us in the prevention of disease within the community.
Hi, my name is Kay Anderson and I work as an Advanced Nurse Practitioner, also known as an ANP, with an Inverglide Health and Social Care Partnership. Advanced Nurse Practitioners are educated to Master's level and we are responsible for the complete patient care journey from start to finish. Advanced Nurse Practitioners can carry out a wide range of specialised tasks similar to your general practitioner. These include prescribing medications, carrying out clinical assessments, ordering investigations such as x-rays and ultrasounds, interpreting blood results, making referrals and arranging admissions to hospital. Given our enhanced level of skill, you may be asked to see an advanced nurse practitioner as an alternative to your GP. Our team of community nurses offer a wide range of specialised services in partnership with your GP. These include acute house visits, as well as specialised services for learning disabilities and frailty, which focuses on geriatric medicine and the care of older adults. Our ethos is realistic medicine to ensure patients receive the right care in the right place by the most appropriate person. We work in partnership with your GP and the multidisciplinary team to ensure patients receive the highest standards of care.
Hello, my name is Margot and I'm a consultant physiotherapist specialising in musculoskeletal physiotherapy. Now you might be wondering what musculoskeletal means. Well, this is problems that involve your joints, muscles, or your bones. And these can be caused by injury, but can also be problems for no real apparent reason. These are things like sprains or strains involving perhaps sore knees, shoulders or backs. Now, you might come across me or one of my colleagues in a variety of settings, including health centres, hospitals or GP practices.
Physiotherapists are expert in managing people who present with musculoskeletal problems. To help us understand what's going on and what's important to you, we need to ask you information about the problems you're having, carry out a detailed assessment, and sometimes we might also organise other investigations such as x-rays, scans or even blood tests. We then work with you to help determine the best way to manage your problem. There is a range of options that we consider, such as appropriate advice and exercises to help you self-manage your problem. Consider painkillers or other medication, some one-to-one physiotherapy support or group-based activities, onward referral to other services for a specialist opinion, for example, orthopaedics or rheumatology. What is right for one person is not necessarily the same for another person. That's why it's important that we understand about you as a person, your lifestyle and what matters most to you. We work in collaboration with GPs and other healthcare professionals to make sure you see the right person at the right time. I want to show you our website, It's really easy to use and is a fantastic resource with lots of advice and exercises on a range of conditions. Many people have used this to help them self-manage their condition or guide them about when they may need to seek the help from a healthcare professional. Musculoskeletal problems can take a few weeks to settle down, but they generally do, especially if we do the right things. We detail all of this on our website for you and steps to be taken should things not go as expected. So if you do develop a joint, muscle or bone problem, remember that physiotherapists are ideally placed to help you with this. Our patients report having found this extremely beneficial, and 95% of patients would recommend us to family and friends.
Hi, my name's Elaine Cannon. I'm the team lead for the Community Link Worker Service in Inverclyde. All 13 practices in Inverclyde have an assigned community link worker. The purpose of community link workers being the GP practices as part of the multidisciplinary team is to take pressure off GPs when patients are presenting with issues that are non-medical. This enables GPs to focus on their clinical role. We know many people go to their GP when they're feeling stressed, anxious or low in mood about circumstances in life which are impacting their overall health and well-being. Examples of this could be around their housing situation, overcrowding and repairs, finances, social opportunities, legal issues, caring issues, and many more. We can also support referrals to other services and resources. This is what's often referred to as social prescribing. Our Community Link Worker team are highly skilled and trained to deliver the professional service you would expect from your GP practice team, and we work to the same high standards of confidentiality. As a team, we keep up to date with what is available in your local community and wider resources, which means we can provide information about a range of options from which patients can choose. Our aim is to work alongside patients to remove any barriers to engaging with agencies or services that they need or want. We will support patients in whatever way works best for them. Your Community Link Worker can be accessed by contacting your GP practice to request a referral to be made to the Practice Link Worker. There is no need for a GP appointment in order to do this, or any complicated referral process, and the practice team will forward your details on to the appropriate community link worker who will then contact you. However, if you're due to attend an appointment at the practice for a medical need but also wish to access your link worker, then the reception team, the GP, the advanced nurse practitioner, practice nurse, physio, pharmacist will also be happy to do this for you. We are delighted to be part of the multidisciplinary team at the GP practice in order to support patients to get to the right person at the right place and at the right time.
My name is Alan Crawford. I'm Service Manager at Community Mental Health Services for Inverclyde Health and Social Care Partnership. We know mental health and wellbeing needs to be considered in equal terms of physical health and wellbeing. GPs can have a role in supporting and managing the care of some mental health conditions, and Community Mental Health Services provide treatment for people experiencing severe and long-term mental health conditions. However, for many mental health issues, there are resources and supports that can be accessed online, via telephone or in your local area.
So if I have questions about mental health or concerns about my own or someone else's, where can I find information?
NHS Inform is an online resource and has information on identifying, treating and managing mental health problems. It also has a range of mental health and self-help guides covering issues like anxiety, depression, self-esteem and sleep. There's an NHS Inform wellbeing tool where users answer a short series of questions and are then recommended online courses or alternatives. Mind to Mind is another NHS Inform resource that contains videos which include suggestions and tips from people with lived experience of mental health difficulties. There's also a dedicated section on NHS Inform called Surviving Suicidal Thoughts. It covers information on getting help with suicidal thoughts or helping someone who's experiencing suicidal thoughts. NHS 24 mental health telephone services are available to everyone in Scotland and are contactable by dialing 111. The NHS 24 Mental Health Service can listen, offer advice and guide you to further help if this is required. You can contact the service if you're feeling distressed, suicidal or in need of emotional support.
I didn't realise there was so much information and support available. These look great, but what should I do if I have looked at the information and tried the self-help guides and I'm still struggling?
Within Inverclyde, there's a range of services that can offer you support. You can self-refer to the primary care mental health team, who offer appointments in their GP practice, and will work with you to identify whether short-term group or or individual support that would be helpful. This team can help with anxiety, depression and other common mental health issues. They may also suggest or refer you to other services. If you're experiencing significant distress, you can be referred to the Distress and Grief Intervention Programme, which provides intensive support for a short time period. Your community link worker or GP can make a referral to the Distress and Grief Intervention Programme. Like physical health and wellbeing, it's important that we all look after our own mental health and wellbeing to ensure we're as well as we can be and able to live life to the full.
Hi, I'm Louise. I'm part of your receptionist team.
You may talk to me or one of my colleagues when you call your GP practice, and we may ask you some questions that will help us get you the right care in the right place. Your receptionists are here to navigate you through our primary care services and make sure you get the care you need. We do this by asking you a few important questions that allow us to get a better picture of your needs and how we can help. The information you share in these calls is confidential, and we will never ask you something that doesn't help you get the care that you need. Our aim is to navigate you through the health services we have available and make sure we get you to the professional that can help you best. And sometimes this might not be your GP. Instead, it might be one of our specialist advanced nurse practitioners, or we might direct you to the community treatment and care or your local pharmacy. This is because the way your healthcare is delivered is changing, and sometimes seeing the GP isn't the right choice for getting you the right care. Your receptionists are here to put the pieces of the puzzle together and get you the primary care that you need. When you call us, we'll be here to help.